Hi, my name is Sue DeJeji. I am a physiatrist or a specialist in physical medicine and rehab. I am the chief and chair of physical medicine and rehab, and I work part-time in the Office of Education at the Royal College of Physicians and Surgeons of Canada. I have an interest in communication skills teaching and training. The CanMEDS Communicator role in 2015 actually looked at the patient-physician encounter very specifically. In previous iterations in CanMEDS 2000, for instance, it looked at the relationships and the communication between team members as well, and that has been removed into the collaborator role. So the focus really is on building therapeutic relationships with patients, providing structure to how the interview is done, to how you provide information to patients, how you develop structure in terms of your encounter, and also deals with written communication skills as well. So it's what you document in your progress notes, it is the information that you send to physicians in the form of a consultation letter, operative reports, and so on. The role of communicator is an essential clinical skill. So in the same way that physical examination, critical thinking, all those skills are essential to the practice of medicine, and communication skills are similar. They are an essential skill to our practice as physicians. There are lots of things that go along with being a good communicator. It starts with your self-awareness. So knowing what are my feelings, thoughts, values, beliefs, even biases. When I'm working with a patient population, in certain environments, with a particular patient. So it's being aware of that and the lens that that brings to the interaction. So that's the first thing. The other is also having the expertise, naturally, so the content that you're going to bring to an encounter. But as importantly, it is how you communicate with patients. So what skills will I use as I begin the interaction, how I establish trust and a relationship with my patients. It is how I'm organized in delivering and in bringing information forward, how I get information from patients that also takes into account their perspective. It is also how I finish an encounter in a way that leaves a patient thinking that I understand what's happened, I know the plan, I know what'll happen if the plan doesn't work. So it's all of those things, and in addition to that, it's how I document what I've done, the interaction, and making sure that that information is sent to the appropriate physicians or other team members.